Hi, it's Dr. Lori, and I'm back with more real bargains. These are the objects that people are finding, people like you, at thrift stores, flea markets, yard sales, estate sales, online, everywhere, and they're asking me to identify them and tell them the value. So here we go. Everybody gave me permission to retell the stories, and boy, are they good stories. Okay, the first story is from my Priority Ask Dr. Lori service, where people send me images of objects, and I appraise them, evaluate them for them, to identify them for him and tell him what it's worth. So this guy wants this table. He's looking for this particular table. He's looking for a table. He looks at an online auction and he's bidding on an online auction for this mid-century modern wheat formed table with a glass top. Very, very 1950s, 1960s. He wants this specific table. He bids in the online auction. He loses the bid. He doesn't get the table. Okay. So then he looks on Craigslist. He's looking around on Craigslist. He's looking around on social media and he tries to find the table. Well, wouldn't you know it, he does find the table. He finds another table and it's selling for $40, only 40 bucks. He's like, wow, this is great. He's like, I'm gonna get this for 40 bucks. So he gets in touch with the seller. The seller's nearby and the seller says, look, I can't do anything. I do have to tell you there's a little chip in the table, but if you come right now, I'll give it to you for 30 bucks. He goes, I'm coming right now, right now. I would come right now too, wouldn't you? You'd be like in the car, like let's go. Close everything, who cares? Leave the doors open, unlock, just go. So 30 bucks. He gets to the place, the storage place where this guy is selling the piece that he found online. And he gives him the 30 bucks. He goes, Dr. Lori, I was so happy. He goes, I wanted this table. This table is beautiful. What is his table? His table is an Eicholtz Bonheur Hollywood Regency gold, of course, gold round iron table with the wheat sheaths at the bottom holding up the whole dining room table. It's a wonderful statement piece from the mid-century modern era. It's about 43 by 23 by 18 or 16, so about that. So anyway, he gets the table, he brings it home, it looks beautiful, he's so happy, he's like, I paid 30 bucks, Dr. Lori, what's it worth? What's it worth? It's worth $4,500. Oh my gosh, what a real bargain. A beautiful piece, a statement piece. If you wanted to actually do some restoration on that little tiny chip, you could, or you could just leave it alone. It's still worth $4,500. That's a real bargain, right out of the chute. This next real bargain comes from a video call. My video calls are a lot of fun. It is fun to talk to all of you on video calls, and it's fun for you to have an opportunity to get an appraisal from me live, right in person on my video calls. So, this couple has this particular painting, bought two of these paintings. These paintings are signed and they bought them from an online estate auction. You know the estate auctions that they do online, because you know you have the regular estate auction where you walk in, the estate sale where you walk in and you look around a house, and then they put these stuff on online too, so to get more, of course, interest in these objects. So they buy two paintings. They buy them for $2.50 each. And they said, well, we didn't really know what we had, but we saw that they were signatures. Well, the subject matter is, of course, game. So it's dead game. It's a dead bird or a dead rabbit or this. And I recognize the artist's name. The artist is Michelangelo Mucci. Michelangelo Mucci is active in the late 1800s. That means he's painting in the late 1800s. And he paints this kind of subject matter. So he's very well known for painting these kinds of things. He paints this, they pay $2.50 at the estate sale. And I said, well, it's a nice piece. It's oval and it's in the frame. I said, did it come in the frame? They said, yeah, Dr. Lori, it came in the frame. I said, for a $5 investment for two paintings, guess what they're worth? $900 each. That's 1,800 bucks for a $5 investment online. If you know what you're looking for, and I'm gonna teach you what to look for, you can really find real bargains right online too. This next real bargain comes from my Priority Ask Dr. Lori service, and this guy was just, this warmed my heart. This was a wonderful story. This is a wonderful story. So this gentleman says to me, well, Dr. Lori, I want to show you this particular object. He starts showing me this object, and I get two or three of them back to back, and they're all pre-Columbian bowls. So they're clay bowls, they're fired at a high temperature, or they're clay figures of ladies or clay figures of dogs, and they're all pre-Columbian, right? So you've seen these, I'm sure, in places like the Southwest and California and Mexico and Peru and great places of course, Central and South America and such. So he says, well, this particular piece I got at a yard sale. And I said, well, tell me about it. He said, well, I've amassed a collection, Dr. Laurie. I said, well, tell me about your collection. He said, well, my collection all started with my wife. My wife brought me to a yard sale. I didn't really want to go, but she asked me if I would accompany her to a yard sale. So I went to the yard sale with her. I drove her to this yard sale. While I was at this yard sale, I looked and I found this little bowl. And this little bowl I got for a dollar. So I bought it for a dollar, and on the way home, I was driving home with my wife, and I explained to her why I bought the bowl. She said, I don't understand why you bought that bowl. I said, well, I bought this bowl because when I was a child and I was growing up, my uncle farmed a land. My grandfather farmed land, and this is a bowl that he would find in the land that he would cultivate in the Southwest, Mexico, and that neck of the woods. He said he cultivated the land, and then he would just come upon these particular artifacts, like these little bowls. So as kids, we used to play with these. So when I saw it at the yard sale, I thought, oh, for a dollar, I'm going to buy it. So since the yard sale, he started to collect these pieces. He works in construction. He goes all over for his work. So he goes from town to town in construction, and he basically picks up pieces, maybe at a thrift store, at a flea market, a yard sale, when he's in these towns for work. So he found other pieces, wonderful pieces, like the Jalisco bowl, like a Tuscaquesa pretty lady is what they're called, this figure, and many pieces that he has found for a dollar to $10, maybe to a little bit more money for each individual one, but he usually only pays no more than about $10 for each particular piece that he buys at a flea market, a yard sale, or of course, a thrift store. He's amassed a pretty good collection in the last 5 years. He has about 70 pieces, which he showed to me. And they have a very high value as a collection. What are they worth? $30,000 for the collection of his pre-Columbian sculptural pottery that he's amassed with just a couple dollars here and there at thrift stores and yard sales. What a real bargain and a real heartwarming story that is. My next real bargain comes from a video call. And I had a couple on the video call. So they're a couple, and they said, well, we go to thrift stores every once in a while. We go to the Goodwill, and we like to shop. So this one day, I was a little tired. I brought my wife to the Goodwill, and I said to her, well, you go in and start looking, and I'm going to sit here and rest a little bit here in our truck. So she goes into the store, and he's in the truck, and within a minute or two, she's texting him, please come in, please come in. I have something big. I need you to carry it out. I found something great. So he's like, gosh, I didn't even get a minute to take a rest. He goes into the thrift store and he finds these with his wife. And he helps her, of course, pay for them and carry them out. So they are, of course, Ty Wilson works on paper. They are two prints by Ty Wilson, the great 1980s artist. He was known for travel posters. He was known for these sort of cards, these images that you saw everywhere on record album covers and on cards and on posters, travel posters of certain places in the 1980s. You even probably remember sort of those images that would come at you on MTV, on music television, of Ty Wilson imagery during music videos. So I like music videos. Music videos are a lot of fun. You know, it gives you a chance to kind of dance when nobody's watching. I'm a good nobody's watching dancer. Anyway, so these particular pieces are, they buy them at the Goodwill, and they pay $6 for two of them. They're in very good shape. Of course, one of them is sort of a travel one with little bits of gold in it, looking at, of course, New York and looking at the bridge, the two lovers. They're usually lovers. And then the other one is more like Valentine's with the big bouquet, and you can see, of course, they're dressed up for a night out with the big bouquet behind the gentleman's back. That particular piece, of course, also cost them $3 of the $6. So $3 each, two works of art in frames, pretty big, right? Poster size, right? Value on them, $500 for the set of two. $250 each with the frame, a 1980s real bargain. This next real bargain also comes from the thrift store. And I was talking on a video call to a client, and she said, you know, Dr. Laurie, I've spent $10 at the thrift store that day, and I got this bowl of fruit, and I got another item. And I didn't really care about the other item, but this bowl of fruit was just sitting there. I couldn't leave it there. A lot of you say that to me when I'm talking to you. A lot of you say to me, I just couldn't leave it there, Dr. Laurie, or nobody was bidding at the auction, and I felt bad for the object. You're funny. You're like me about objects. I felt bad for it. Nobody wanted it. Well, that was the case with this particular fruit bowl. Fruit bowls and the idea of having fruit as a centerpiece goes back very, very far, but it goes back for this for our purposes, for this discussion, back to the late 1800s after the Civil War, when paintings of theorem paintings, which are usually paintings of fruit and still life paintings, become pretty prominent. Not that they weren't important before that time period, but they become prominent in many homes during that time. So, first of all, in the 19th century, what you would have in the 1800s is actual stoneware fruit, and then it would be painted. So it's ceramic or stoneware, and then they'd paint it the colors of fruit. That's what you have here. This one is a late 19th, early 20th century example with the fruit bowl. It's pretty rare to still have the fruit bowl because usually bowls get separated out. You know, like the waste bowl in a tea set, that usually gets separated out. Well, this didn't get separated out. So late 19th, early 20th century, about the turn of the 20th century, fruit bowl and then the pieces of fruit. Now, the pieces of fruit include a pomegranate, a peach, an apple, a banana, and a watermelon. And they're all in the bowl. And then the bowl is of the same style, right? It looks kind of primitive, but really of the same style. The watermelon has a little bit of damage. So I said, well, the watermelon, was it like that when you bought it? She said, yeah, I bought this and another item for $10. And so the watermelon was like that, but I didn't really care. It didn't really bother me. And over time, the age really doesn't seem to sort of stick out, you know, and kind of attract your eye too badly with these pieces because they've had time to have more age on them. So she buys the piece for $10. She brings it home. She talks to me on the video call, and I get to tell her that her turn of the century stoneware painted fruit and fruit bowl is worth $400 for the group. What a nice real bargain, and an interesting part of how, of course, the history happens. Because after those fruit bowls that are made of stoneware and ceramic, then we go to wax fruit and then we go to plastic fruit. So wax fruit in the 1920s, 30s, 40s, and plastic fruit from the 50s through the 70s. That's a real bargain. This next real bargain comes from a student and his mom. I'm on a video call with a mother of a graduate school student who's trying to raise money for his graduate school loans. He's trying to pay back debt. Aren't we all trying to pay back debt? Whether it's, of course, debt from holiday shopping or debt from, of course, a car payment or debt from school loans or debt from who knows what, just trying to make ends meet. So he's trying to pay down debt, and his mom calls and says, I want to know about this piece that he found in the Goodwill. So he went to the Goodwill and he bought this particular piece. He bought this piece and he bought another piece like it. So both of them are pictures of cathedrals. It's kind of interesting. So I appraised both of them during our video call, and I said, well, that one piece is a print, and it's a print of a famous cathedral. It's worth maybe about $25. She said, okay, maybe the other one's worth that too. I said, well, let me take a look at it. So I look at the second one. She shows me the second one. And the second one is actually pretty special. It is a watercolor work of art by an artist named Edwin Dolby. And Dolby is a British artist who's active in the 19th century. He paints watercolors of famous places. Well, this is a famous place. This is, of course, the Cathedral and the Dome of Milan, Italy, also known as the Duomo of Milano, or the Dome of Milan. And it is a very, very important site. It's a pilgrimage site for Christians who are trying to go to all of the important cathedrals of the medieval time. This cathedral was actually begun or started to be built in 1386, and it wasn't finished until the 1800s. So it took many, many centuries to actually build it. The Duomo is very, very famous, like other, of course, domes throughout Italy and major sites like Rome and like, of course, Florence and other places. I love Italy personally. I think it's a great place. It's so happy and it's so dynamic and vivacious. I just love Italy. Well, I'm biased. Anyway, so this particular piece by the British artist, this particular piece has many prints like it. So they would actually take this watercolor and they would reproduce it into other prints. So it was one of the great stops on the Grand Tour if people were touring and travelers. And this particular piece he purchased for $2 in a frame. It's 18 by 13 and value on the piece, $700. That's a real bargain and a beautiful work of art. I was able to tell them how to identify the watercolor, make sure it wasn't a print, by using their loupe, right? And also by utilizing the texture, really looking for a certain aspect of the texture. It's a real bargain. My next real bargain comes from Italy too. Well, by way of America, I guess. This particular piece is from a video call. So I met a woman on a video call and she said, well, Dr. Lori, I've got a couple things, but this is the last thing I'll show you. So she had shown me some other things before she showed me these two vessels. So she has these vessels and I said, is there a mark on the bottom? I said, they look Italian and they look early, middle part of the 1900s. So mid-century modern, 1950s, 1960s. She said, yeah, it says Raymor. She said, it doesn't really make sense to me. It says Italy, but it says Raymor. Well, in fact, Raymor is the name of an export company in the United States that brought into the United States and into furniture stores of the 1950s and 60s examples of Scandinavian design pottery and Italian ceramics and Italian glass and other pieces by great designers who are working in that time period. So these particular pieces are both marked Raymor. The export company is in business from about World War II to about 1980, bringing all of these types of modern pieces into the United States. So if you're in a thrift store, if you're in a yard sale, you're at an estate sale and you wonder what Raymor is all about, it was someone in America saying, hey, I've got a great idea. I'm gonna bring these pieces in and sell them to the Americans who aren't traveling at this particular point in time after World War II, right? Makes sense. So they had a great catchphrase for this, or they said, modern in the tradition of good taste. This particular example here has the indicative Raymor mark on it. And this particular piece was purchased some years ago. She said that she probably bought it anywhere between 5 and 10 years ago. And she's had the two pieces together. She liked the pink color, kind of a dusty rose color. She said it went with her furniture throughout the 1980s when dusty rose was in. I was in my cousin's wedding and I was the maid of honor and I had to wear dusty rose and the dusty rose hat. And I won't forget it. And I looked like in a dress of like this color. So it was big in the 80s, even though these pieces are from the 60s. So it fit into her home decor, and she said she knows she bought them for about $10 each, 20 bucks for the two of them. What are they worth? $400 each. They're really nice examples of mid-century modern, and they're a real bargain too. I'm Dr. Lori. Stay right here, share the channel, learn what you should be looking for so you can find your real bargain. And as always, I thank you for watching, and I hope you find your real bargain real soon.